Some of the more common Penn State ghost stories, perhaps the most well-known is Mrs. Atherton. There's two of them about her. One is that she is in Schwab Auditorium looking over the grave where George Atherton is buried right outside and just looking over him. The other Mrs. Atherton ghost story is Old Botany, which is right across the street from where the Atherton grave site is. And Mrs. Atherton, again, is watching over George Atherton. And, you know, if it's quiet and it's dark and you can see lights up in the dormer windows at the top of the building where she's looking over at George Atherton. And then perhaps one of the oldest ghost stories has to do with the Ghost Walk. And the Ghost Walk was a series of trees that back in the day would have gone from the rear of what is now Old Botany, beyond where Burroughs Building is now, to where, past the library, to where the child care center is on what is Allen Street to Park Avenue. The horticulture on campus was originally designed by William Waring, who was a horticulturist and a botanist, and he was one of the first founders of the school and a principal at the school, and he laid out the groundworks. And part of what he laid out was, when Old Botany was built, was to put a greenhouse and a growing facility behind Old Botany, and behind that was this series of trees. And because these trees were so dense, it was a great place for young couples to go walking, where they wouldn't necessarily be rules and restrictions by the dean of women or the dean of men or the faculty. There is this picture that is actually a staged photograph that was done by a botany professor, William Buckout. It's a superimposed photo to create what looks like ghosts walking through the Ghost Walk. And it's actually his daughters who were inside the costumes when he did this. But the tradition had to do with sneaking into the Ghost Walk, being in the Ghost Walk, not being found, and so spiriting in and out of the Ghost Walk. Unfortunately, most of the Ghost Walk is now gone, because the first part was destroyed when Burroughs Building was put up. The second part was destroyed when the library expanded to include what's now the Paterno Wing. And then the third part is where the Esper buildings are. So it's interesting to me that the tradition and the stories of the Ghost Walk continues when the physical space really doesn't exist anymore.